Tenía un hogar estable y lo perdí. Lo perdí todo. Todo, todo.
How do you survive in a war zone? What do you do when trapped between armed groups? Where do you go when the rules of war are not respected? Putting your life in peril. Forcing you to flee. Separating you from loved ones. To assist and protect people in war is the mission of the International Committee of the Red Cross, the ICRC.
Je veux améliorer l'accès le plus rapidement possible pour le CICR pour les gens qui ont besoin d'assistance. Et je suis extrêmement préoccupé par les problèmes d'accès, notamment pour des gens blessés dans certains villages.
To access people trapped by conflict, the ICRC remains neutral and independent. Working with Red Cross and Red Crescent societies maximizes the chances of reaching people. The ICRC staff and Lebanese Red Cross volunteers deliver food and medical supplies. As being injured can be fatal when medical services are stretched to the limit, the ICRC delivers emergency supplies to scores of hospitals. But when fighting takes place in remote areas with no access to medical care, even the slightest injury can be fatal. Mobile surgical teams perform war surgery and health teams provide basic care. Everyone is treated strictly according to needs, civilians or fighters, no matter what side they're on. Every year, millions flee their homes searching for safe refuge. This despite the rights civilians have under the rules of war, international humanitarian law, to be protected. Internally displaced people suffer extreme hardship, vulnerable to violent attacks and abuse, forced to find new ways to survive. Listening and understanding how people are coping is crucial.
You came here willingly? You wanted to come here because...
No, we did not want to come here because in town there was no toilets, there was no water.
Understanding the situation helps the ICRC to assess basic needs. Safe drinking water and decent sanitation are a priority to prevent the emergence of diseases. Local residents often share their resources with displaced people. The ICRC steps in to meet the needs of both displaced and local communities. These families are moving back to their village. They're given help to get their lives back on track. Seeds and tools to plant their crops before the rain start.
Yes.
The ICRC makes it a priority to prevent displacement, helping people to maintain their livelihoods. The ICRC and Red Cross and Red Crescent Tracing Network works to alleviate the trauma of family separation. It operates worldwide to help find missing relatives. A tracing team has located the mother of 16-year-old Amelia, stranded in a Guinean refugee camp after fleeing Liberia's civil war. The team meets Amelia and her babies at the border.
Welcome back to Liberia, Amelia. Welcome back to
Liberia. Amelia hasn't seen her family for several years.
You see, they've made you. Maybe we stop here.
Deprived of freedom, cut off from family and society. Risk of disappearance and ill treatment. Harsh prison conditions. Detainees are vulnerable and need protection. ICRC staff visit annually 500,000 detainees in nearly 80 countries. Confidential dialogue with prison staff, monitoring conditions, and private interviews with detainees are carried out. The aim is to protect prisoners from all forms of abuse. Basic healthcare is fundamental to protecting detainees. In Central Asia, the levels of tuberculosis are very high. The ICRC works with prison staff to treat and combat the spread of the disease. Reducing infection beyond the prison gates. Governments must allow detainees and families to exchange news. Red Cross messages are important emotional lifelines. For this man, it's the only link with his brother-in-law, interned in Guantanamo Bay. Some families in Afghanistan haven't seen their sons for over a year. A new video link with the U.S. detention center in Bagram provides proof that both sides are alive and well. But when possible, the ICRC organizes visits between detainees and their families, as there's no substitute for seeing a loved one. How do you protect civilians struggling to survive in a climate of violence? International humanitarian law is a set of rules that place restrictions on the use of weapons and methods of warfare. The ICRC runs training programs, explaining this law to all weapons bearers, armed groups. As well as military, police, and other armed forces.
What value has it got?
instructing teachers is one of the most effective ways of promoting the law with future generations. The ICRC reminds authorities during wartime of their obligations under international humanitarian law, as in the 2006 Lebanon conflict with Israeli and Lebanese leaders. And in peacetime, it meets with members of the international community to promote the law. The law limits how and which weapons can be used. Cluster munitions contaminate large areas with unexploded submunitions, posing a serious threat to civilians. Tens of thousands of people have been killed or wounded, especially children. The ICRC works intensively with the international community to prohibit their use. In Dublin, 110 states agreed to a worldwide ban on the use, production, stockpiling and transfer of cluster munitions. International humanitarian law gives the ICRC the right to assist and protect people in war, bringing relief to wounded, assisting displaced, visiting prisoners of war, or reuniting families. By remaining neutral and independent, the ICRC can be where needed, ensuring that those protected by the law are treated with respect and dignity.